In this video, we'll take an example where there are three particles A, B, C, which are at the corners of equilateral triangle. Let this be the point where the bisectors of all three angles meet, and this point be O. This will be, if the each side is A, this will be A upon root 3. They are moving with velocity v, and the condition is that each particle will move in such a way that it is looking towards the next particle. Means B will always be pointing towards C, C is pointing towards A, A is pointing towards B. Appears simple, but it is not as simple as it appears, because the directions constantly keeps on changing because each point is shifting its location. If the movement starts like this, where the particles were at the corners, there is no problem. But now when, say, some movement has taken place, let us take, this is the small, we are showing large distance here, but to just to have a clarity in the picture, otherwise it's a very small distance which we have to take. This is first movement. Now the second movement is interesting. It will have to be in this direction, like this, because C has changed its location. And C will be moving in the second movement in this direction, and A will be moving in this direction. Now, this is the new corner points of another equilateral triangle. And if you draw bisectors, they will again meet at the same point. Bisectors will meet at the same point. Let me take the third stage also. Let it move like this. It will move like this. It will move like this. And after that movement, another triangle will be formed. And if you take the bisectors again from the corners, they will again meet at the same point. So if you carefully notice in this diagram, the direction of motion, that is velocity, is always making 30 degrees with this line which is joining the center and the location from where it starts moving. Initially it started from here. This is the velocity, 30 degree was the angle. Now it is starting from here, but moving in this direction. This is now again 30 degree. So every time, every small time lapses or the distances which we have taken, they are always, the velocity is always making 30 degree with this line. Now if you draw arcs like this, drop the arcs from here to the original line. If you draw the arcs, these distances which it has, like this is the arc, this is the distance it has traveled. It will be approximately, means equal to this one. So all these arcs will sum up to A upon root 3. If I draw it again for clarity, this is the first one. Now the second movement is in this direction, and the line joining O becomes like this. The another movement is again in this direction. The line joining is like this. You have to make it with compass so that you get good results. I'm just drawing in a rough manner. So these are the lines from the corners of the triangles. Initially this was the corner, then this, and this is the velocity. You draw arcs like this. Arcs, drop it here. And this is equal to this. Likewise, you will get different segments. So what is the component of velocity in this direction for this distance? It is v cos 30. That is v root 3 upon 2 is the velocity component with this distance. All these distance will add up to a upon root 3, so total distance is a upon root 3. And the velocity component, I have said, is v root 3 upon 2 along these small distances which add up to a upon root 3. So we can find time is equal to, this v dash is equal to sigma of all distances dx, which was equal to d upon t. So t will be, d is a upon root 3 upon v dash. V dash is how much? A upon root 3, and v dash is v root 3 upon 2. So time will be twice a upon 3v. This is the time when time taken by the particles to come to this point O where all three will meet. In the similar manner, we can do the problem where it is a case of a hexagon also. Basic thing which has to be kept in mind is the angle which the velocity is making with these distances which add up to the total distance, displacement. This is the displacement. Final initial point and final point. This is the displacement is a upon root 3, and velocity is always making an angle of 30 degree with this displacement, as I have shown by taking these arcs. That is why we get this result. So that is all on this problem. Thank you.